What's up, everybody? William Tackett here, and today we are going over one of my recent training rounds with one of my friends, Kemoy Anderson. Kemoy Anderson is a 10th Planet representative and a really cool competitor, cool guy overall, and we had a really fun round in the gym the other day, so I wanted to share it with you guys and break it down as best as possible. So I hope you guys enjoy. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video before we get started, and let's go ahead and get into it. So sorry about the lens fogging up, but kind of fogged up a lot in this round. We were pretty much going at it the whole time. As you can see there, Kemoy hits a really nice snap down by holding my head and hitting that really nice timed ankle pick off of when I'm trying to posture back up. Really good takedown and really exhaust your opponent. So nice technique there by Kemoy. You notice us here with good head position. Both of us are fighting for that inside position with the head, both leading forward. For me, I'm trying to really push into Kemoy and get him to push back into me. I'm trying to work some snaps, as you can see there, and really trying to get him to commit to something by pushing forward. That way I can counter. Still trying to drive into him. This time I have a little bit of like a scarf hold style grip. I was looking for a lat drop if he put some weight back into me, but he never really did. He was keen to it. And from there I tried to hit a shot, but wasn't able to. From here I hit just kind of like timed, hitting an underhook and getting that body lock position. I was able to actually pull Kemoy down to the mat. And you can see that lens fogging up there again. Sorry about that, guys. From here, I'm trying to pass Kemoy's guard. I'm trying to use that underhook and knee slice off to the side. And Kemoy's framing my head pretty hard, but wasn't able to repummel the underhook is really what he should have been doing there to avoid the pass. But basically by pushing my head, it allowed me to still knee slice, top side control, and then work my way into mount here. I kind of have that quarter mount here. I actually typically like to use this, kind of feed my foot. It gets my partner to turn on their side and start trying to create space there, and it normally allows me to get that underhook that I now have. But the problem with trying to do this to Kemoy is Kemoy's upper body is so strong that I can pretty much have one, two, as many underhooks as I want, and really good head position, cross face, all of it, and it's so hard to hit top submissions on him, especially on his upper body. He's just really strong, good at defending, and it's tough. It's just really tough. So as you see, I kind of abandon the mount there, and I look to transition to this guillotine here. I think it's an arm end guillotine, as we can see, and I think I end up falling to my back and trying to change it now to this anaconda style grip, but I wasn't able to figure for my hands. I was just keeping that ratchet, and I didn't close it soon enough, and he was able to spin out. Good job there by Kemoy. Working back to our feet, I'm trying to work some snaps. I was actually able to hit a counter sprawl there to a arm drag and hit a reshot as we stood back up and get that takedown. Kemoy almost had that Kimura grip, which is a really good counter when you're trying to defend a takedown, and especially for someone like Kemoy, he has a really good Kimura, so it's a good attack there for him, but he wasn't able to complete it, and I was able to find my way to this top position. I'm not for sure if I'm in mount yet. I guess I am. Yes, I'm in mount here, and I have my foot still caught, but as you notice, I'm now back stepping and trying to go to his legs. From here, I like to do this against people that I can't really submit their upper body. Maybe they're a little strong for me. I always look to re-enter into the legs. You might have seen this in my matches at the trials. I wasn't able to pass my opponent's guard fully because he had my lockdown, so I was able to backstep into his legs. Or back in, I think, 2019 at the BJJ Fanatics Invitational, I was able to do that rolling samurai roll into a calf slicer from mount, just because I wasn't able to peel my opponent's elbows away from the side. So you might be able to see that more here in this roll. I believe I go for it once more, but notice I'm just trying to put really heavy shoulder pressure here on Kemoy, getting to him to kind of create some space and allow me to kind of take that space away by just applying really heavy shoulder pressure. My fingers are in his armpit here, so it actually makes him look into his own shoulder and makes it really uncomfortable. But I got a little off balance there and he bumped me off of him, and now he's playing his X guard. I was able to high step out there by controlling his feet and back stepping, and land in this almost twister side control. I think this is where I start to enter into the legs again, like I was mentioning earlier, where I'm able to get that twister hook. I roll through. Notice how I'm holding Kemoy's hips. Kemoy and I normally have some really good battles from this position in rolling. He's really good from here. It's a pretty 10th Planet-esque style move, where they call it the truck roll. There are other people call it the samurai roll. It's, you know, all the same, but from here it's a battle of hip position. So I'm trying to get my hips to the ground and his off the floor. Notice we're both scooping each other's hips, trying to prevent that from happening. But basically, eventually I'm able to get Kemoy's hips enough by rocking there, get my hips to the ground. Notice how I'm able to now start locking up his leg in this calf slice grip. He's able to sit up and hand fight for quite a while and just hit like a leg extension, prevent me from finishing. So it took a little bit of patience here. And as you notice, my hips are off the ground. So I have to roll back to get my hips back to the floor. Then I'm able to lock up my hands in a gable. and get that finish there on the calf slice once his knee was bent. It's impossible to do that if their leg's straight, but as soon as you can bend their knee, then you get a nice finish. You can see us there talking about it. In between the next round, it was a really fun scrap there. We always have good fun rolls. And we're back standing. I'm snapping those hands off as he tries to put his hands on my shoulders, and I was able to shoot in and get that single leg to body lock there. And I basically trip him down the backside while still semi being in front of him. Notice how my head's still in front. Really good way to keep your partner from turtling. If your head's behind them, there's really nothing stopping them from turtling. But if you keep your head on their chest, it's really tough for them to now roll to their knees and get to that turtle. I'm able to kind of start settling to this mount position. Notice how I'm using the underhooks to really separate his elbows from his side to make that clearance easy for me to go from side control to mount, even when my opponent's trying to recover. And from here, I'm actually going for an Americana. I've been hitting this quite a bit in training. Not something I expect to get against Kemoy because he's so strong and pretty savvy to it, but I've been hitting it a lot in training where I hit that Americana from there. Kemoy's able to make some space and get to that Sumageshi style grip there, arm and head sweep, but I was able to pull my arm out. And again, you see me backstepping by holding the feet. This is a really good approach to passing someone's guard when they're sitting back trying to attack your legs. You can hold their feet and kind of backstep out. I was able to change it into a kind of topside smash pass there and work around to the backside and again get to mount once more. I'm trying to take a different approach, maybe to hit some mounted triangle from here, because you know, maybe you don't see it much in this role, but for the most part, every time I try to arm triangle or arm bar Kemoy, it just ends up me not being able to get it because I can't get his elbows away from his side. As you notice me really trying to pummel on his left elbow, I get it kind of separated there, but you know, that was the end of the round there. You can see us both pretty tired. So that's the end of the video for today. I hope you enjoyed the round and the commentary over the roll. It was a lot of fun. Always great training with Kemoy. So expect to see him and me more on the channel often. Now that the ADCC trials is coming up, you can expect to see more rounds of myself and you know, everybody else at the Fight Factory. So I appreciate you guys tuning in. As always, make sure to check me out on social media, Instagram, Facebook, and my BJJ Fanatics DVDs. If you like the commentary, I guarantee you guys will like the BJJ Fanatics videos. I have two. I have one on body lock passing to the back, and I have another one on escapes. I have a few more coming out soon, so make sure to stay tuned up with everything, and just keep an eye out for all the new future videos. I appreciate you guys as always, and yeah, have fun on the mats. I'll see you guys in the next video. God bless.